Well, it's something that many women go through after having a baby: insomnia, crying, and irritability. And it's often called the baby blues. It usually goes away by itself, but sometimes it's much more serious. Only on the Health Beat, Dr. Barry Ramo tells us how to tell if you're just going through a normal phase and when you should seek professional help. Dr. Ramo, a timely topic, something that just came out from the state saying that New Mexico women may be at a higher risk for postpartum depression.
Well, I think I'd be very skeptical about any numbers. I know that they said that the risk of postpartum depression in this state is higher than any place in the country. Really depends on how they measure this, but it's a very common problem, regardless of whether we're number one or number 30.
Right.
It's still an important illness and it needs to be recognized.
Why would we be at a higher risk?
Well, I think number of factors. There are risk factors for postpartum depression. Number one, the younger the mother, the more likely she is to have it. Poverty is a factor. Cigarette smoking is a factor. And also, if a woman has had depression at any time of her life, which is much more common in lower socioeconomic groups, mm-hmm. that puts them at greater risk. So it's certainly logistically possible and feasible that it could have happened.
For those who may not know what it is, what is postpartum depression or baby blues?
Baby blues is really different. Every mother gets a problem after the baby's born. There's often a period of weepiness or sadness, but it's very short-lived. On the other hand, postpartum depression is a problem which is really a manifest depression. Mm. They have problems with self-esteem, they have problems with sleeping, irritability, and there are significant consequences, not only for the mother, but also for the baby and the family.
Yeah, I experienced some baby blues. I mean, it was something that I didn't even recognize at first, and then with each baby, I did have it. But what can some mothers do?
Well, I think number one is that people have to recognize that it exists. I think one of the problems is that women get these symptoms. A lot of people, particularly men, blow them off and say, oh, that's just being a woman. The fact of the matter is that 4 or 5 weeks after pregnancy, if a woman has these symptoms, she needs to recognize them, get to the doctor, and get some help.
Okay, there is help that is available. Consult your doctor if you notice something just isn't right and you're having a hard time taking care of that child.
Right.
Okay, thanks, Dr. Ramo.
You bet.